Sasha Sairin, and right now I'm at Amy Mascara's makeup booth, and today we'll be doing two short videos. One video will be more natural look during the day, and the other one will be more of an evening look. So I'll be doing it step by step, how I put my makeup on. I always start with this Miracle Water. This Miracle Water you can use before you start. And right at the end, whether you're comfortable with having this on your face after you've done your makeup. But actually, it kind of retains your makeup and gives you a fresh look throughout the day after you've applied makeup. Second will be the BB cream. Now, we've heard a lot about the BB creams that's very popular now, but the difference about Amy Mascara's BB cream is that it has a lot of benefits. It's mostly mineral based, and it says yes, you can eat 9-in-1. I'll just tell you some of the benefits here. It can be used as sunblock, and of course sunblock is very important these days when we're out in the sun. It can be used for whitening, for concealer, skin repair, moisturizer, a foundation, oil control, a makeup base, and refines pores, like I said just now. For concealer, skin repair, moisturizer, a foundation, oil control, a makeup base, and refines pores, like I said just now. So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the mineral water. So just light spray it over my face. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply it on half of my face first. And this actually can go with any skin tone, because it's not like a hint, a little hint of foundation. So it's not going to be cakey, it's not going to be too thick. So I'm going to put it on this side of my face first. So I just rub it in like, I prefer using my fingers. Some people might want to use a sponge, use a sponge. I will put it on my face first without my eyes. I want to show you how it can be used as a concealer for the eye area before you put your eyeshadow on. So basically it acts as a base as well. Okay, so now I have the pressed powder, mineral pressed powder, so I'm just gonna lightly, not a lot, just lightly put a little bit of powder. Eyebrows are a bit tricky, and what I like to use from Amy Mascara is actually their eyebrow palette, and use a brush instead of a pencil, use a brush. And what I like about it is that they not only give you two tones for your eyebrows, because you know people have different hair colors, like mine is blonde, somebody might have black hair or brown hair, and usually the lighter your hair is, it's better you stick to the lighter shade instead of using a darker eyebrow pencil. It kind of makes your face look a bit fierce, too fierce sometimes. What I like about this palette is this, and also they give you for if you want to draw light, small light black eyeliner kind of under your eyelid, and also what they give you is like a highlighter. I don't know what you really call it, like a highlighter, I guess, to put under your brow. And that's very important as well, because it helps highlight your eyeshadow later on. Or like in my case, I'm going to be using it to just, again, brighten up the whole eyelid. So your eyes kind of pop out naturally, the color of your eyes. Okay, so I'm going to start off with doing my eyebrows first. So I'm going to put on a little bit of eyeliner, not too much, because I want to show you how it looks like with eyeliner during the day and with eyeliner for when you're going out during the evening, because obviously the eyeliner for during the day will be very thin, just a little bit to make your eyes, again, the color pop out. I already have big eyes, and I know I'm always told my big eyes have big sockets. My eyes, so it's easy for them to put my eyeshadow on. But I feel that when I put eyeliner on, especially when I use liquid eyeliner, that it it does help and enhance my eye, you know, and I like it. Plus, I'm a big Audrey Hepburn fan. I'm a big fan of actresses from the 60s, so you always notice they always have a little bit of eyeliner on. So I'm going to put a little bit of eyeliner on right now. It's taken me many, many years to be able to draw with the eyeliner on, and a lot of practice. But it's really worth it. I mean, I've always loved, like I said, I've always loved eyeliner. And you can really transform this. It's very important. So you do it slowly and take your time. Blush is important because it can help shape your cheekbone, shape your face on how you will look in the end. So this is why I use the sponge first. And other tips is, of course, I don't know when you've heard, like you kind of suck your face in, go like that, so you suck your face in. So you know where your cheekbones are. Alright? Last but not least, we're going to put on lipstick. I actually like red lipstick, but we're going to go a little bit natural for this time. Let's go with, we've got lots of shades here actually. It's kind of like lip gloss, but there's so many shades you can choose from. So for me, I like bright colors, but I'm not going to go with bright red. I'm going to keep that for the evening. So I think I'll use this color first. Oh no, that's pink. I don't want pink. I want this color. Bit of a brownish, reddish